Hallelujah. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Let us sing together. Jesus Christ is risen today. It's on your first hymn of your song sheet.
Thank you.
Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. The other Easter acclamation is, Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death. And the response is, on those in tombs bestowing life. On those in tombs bestowing life. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and on those in tombs bestowing life.
What are we to make of this day, when graves are opened, when the dead awaken, when life refuses to be contained?
That nothing is impossible. Hope is never extinguished, and love is never conquered.
We celebrate you today, Jesus, because you have made it clear that death does not have the last word, because you have filled us again with hope and faith, because you have given us a vision of new possibilities, new realities, and new ways of being.
Open our minds to believe what we cannot explain. Open our hearts to hope for what we cannot see. Open our lives to live and to love in the midst of death and despair. Let resurrection happen again in us today. Amen.
Amen.
Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death,
and on those in tombs bestowing life.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. God, you are the creator of the whole world, the universe, the liberator of your people, and the wisdom of the earth. By the resurrection of your only begotten Jesus, free us from our fears. Restore us in your image, and ignite us with your light. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Sovereign, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated.
The first reading is from the prophet Isaiah, the 25th chapter. On this mountain, God, Yahweh, omnipotent, will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food, a banquet of fine wines, rich food and succulent, and fine aged wines. On this mountain, God will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples, the shroud covering all nations, destroying all death forever. God will wipe away the tears from every cheek, and will take away the shame of God's people on the earth, wherever they live. God has spoken. On that day, it will be said, this is our God. This is the one for whose liberation we waited. God is the one in whom we have hoped. We rejoice expectantly in our deliverance, for the hand of God rests on this mountain. The word of life.
Thanks be to God.
The second reading is from the Acts of the Apostles, the 10th chapter. So Peter said to them, I begin to see how true it is that God shows no partiality, rather that any person of any nationality who fears God and does what is right is acceptable to God. This is the message God has sent to the people of Israel, and the good news of peace proclaimed through Jesus Christ, who is Savior of all. You yourselves know what took place throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee with the baptism John proclaimed. You know how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, and how Jesus went about doing good works and healing all who were in the grip of the devil, because God was with him. We are eyewitnesses to all that Jesus did in the countryside and in Jerusalem. Finally, Jesus was killed and hung on a tree, only to be raised by God on the third day. God allowed him to be seen, not by everyone, but only by the witnesses who had been chosen beforehand by God, that is, by us, who ate and drank with Christ after the resurrection from the dead. And Christ commissioned us to preach to the people and to bear witness that this is the one set apart by God as judge of the living and the dead. To Christ Jesus, all the prophets testify that everyone who believes has forgiveness of sins through this name. The word of life.
Thanks be to God. I'd like to invite all the young people who are here, and if you're feeling young at heart, you're welcome to come forward too, but young people to come gather up here in front of me now. Yeah, babe, come on down. There we go. Cool. Thanks, Kaufman's. Kinskis, boys, if you want to come. Okay. Good morning. Morning. I'm glad you are here. Happy Easter. Thank you. So I want you to turn around and look at that beautiful tree over there. What do you see on that tree?
Flowers.
Yes, the tree is blooming, right? And above the tree, but the top part of the tree, what do you see? The leaves are coming out too, right? So what time, you can look at me now. So what time of year is this? Spring, yeah, it's springtime. And it's a time when we see everything coming back to life. The trees blooming, the leaves coming out. And it's a perfect way to remember what Easter is all about. Easter is about the day that we celebrate that Jesus wasn't dead anymore, but rose to life. This is our happiest and most joyous day because God took Jesus who had died and raised him up. And so the trees and the flowers can all be reminders of that. And as we move through life and you get older, you're going to see other ways that remind us of that too. But it's a day we want to celebrate and be joyous. So some of you are wearing some fun colored shirts and dresses and hats even. I like the styling hat, very cool. And so we dress up. I'm even wearing some fancy duds today too, to celebrate this important special day. We're gonna sing some fun songs that are celebratory. So I wanna give you something to take home with you. You may pick whatever color is your fancy. You get one to have. I'll take that one. Cool. Now these are our celebration ribbons. And so I want you to help us today because, you know, sometimes these people need a little help in getting excited. Right? And so I want you to help them get excited by practicing waving this. You see this? Can you wave this? So anytime we sing, I want you to wave this like crazy. Just don't hit anybody with it, okay? Right? Like a little the deal, right? So we want to try to remind people this is a happy, joyous day. So we're going to practice, and I'm going to have you walk around the group here. We're going to do a little parade just for one little two verses of a song here real quick. And so hit it, Mr. Kirk. And so we're going to practice. And so when we go by, we want to see you smile through your mask and wave, okay?
Thank you.
of our songs today, I want you to help everyone sing, right? And if you want to pretend you're Mr. Kirk and conduct, you may do that too, whatever you like, all right? And so you are important helpers today in today's worship to remind everyone that it's a day of great joy. Okay? Thank you, guys. You guys go back and sit with your families now. I invite you to stand and sing the next song on the song sheet, which is the song that Mr. Kirk just played. Magdala, mother of James, and Salome, brought perfumed oils so that they could anoint Jesus. Very early, just after sunrise on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb. They were saying to one another, "Who will roll back the stone from the entrance of the tomb?" When they looked, they found that the huge stone had already been rolled back. On entering the tomb, they saw a young person sitting at the right, dressed in a white robe. They were frightened, but the youth assured them, "Do not be amazed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, the one who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him? Now go and tell the disciples and Peter, Jesus is going ahead of you to Galilee, where you will see him, just as he told you." They made their way out and fled from the tomb, bewildered and trembling. But they said nothing to anyone, because they were so afraid. The good news of salvation. Glory and praise to our Savior, Jesus Christ. I invite you to be seated. Early on the morning, Mary of Magdala and Salome went to the tomb to do the needful thing. The needful thing was to go and anoint Jesus' body. You see, they had taken his body down from the cross so quickly before the Sabbath, and the men had put him in the tomb before there could be a proper burial. And so the women went to anoint the body, to grieve, to mourn, to do an act of care. We know what it's like to be faced by death and difficulties and the need to do those things. And as they're going, they recall an issue, a stumbling block, a stone. Who's going to roll away the big stone? What are they going to do? In fact, when they get there, the stumbling block, the obstacle, is no longer a problem. It is not there. Their expectations had now shifted. And now, their expectations shift even more, because what they expected to see was Jesus in the tomb, and he is not there. Instead, there is this young man. By the way, this is an allusion earlier in Mark's Gospel. There's another young man who loses his cloak in the garden, whole other story, but they're allusions back to other Hebrew scripture stories of young men showing up proclaiming God's goodness. And so here there's this young man who reminds them that Jesus said that he would die and that he would rise again and meet them. And they're frightened. Their expectation has changed. What they expected to see is not what they saw. And so they were shaken up. And so, like what happens to most of us, when our expectations aren't met, we become frightened. We freeze. And then they flee. Sometimes when people become frightened too, they fight. But not in this case. This is my favorite resurrection story, actually. Because the Gospel of Mark actually ends here at the 8th verse. There are some other, if you look in your Bible, you'll see there's 8 more verses, Pastor. It's really thought that those verses were added many, many, many decades later. That the Gospel seems to have ended there with the 8th verse, with the women fleeing and not telling anyone. Clearly, we know they told somebody sometime, but they left in this sense of confusion and not understanding. It kind of feels like life. Confusion and sometimes not understanding the difficulty that's before us. And so another unique thing about this gospel, which we can't see in English, but it's there in the Greek, is that the last word of those 8 verses in chapter 16 is actually also the same word as the very first word in the gospel. So it's almost like if you didn't get it now, go back to the beginning. And those of you who have been with us know that we have been unpacking and talking about this season what Jesus says the good news is. The good news is that this is the time of fulfillment. The reign of God is at hand. Change your hearts and minds and believe this good news. Believe that the power of God is present. And those who are with us during our Lenten journey, each week we looked at how does God show up and how is God present with us. We talked about in the ways of Jesus' ministry, feeding, including, teaching, healing, and forgiving. We talked about when liberation happens and changes of mind happen. When people take up a cross and follow in the way of love, when they do the hard thing so that another may have life, there we see the presence of the divine. We see the presence of the divine in the cycles of death and resurrection, the little deaths in our own lives and the new births that come. And so the gospel is pointing us back to this. So a year ago, pandemic came, and we had to figure out how to do the needful thing. What is needed? What is needed to raise my family? What is needed to support my friends, to support the church? How do we do things in a safe way? How do we do things so that everyone can feel included as much as possible? And we had to worry about obstacles, some of them which seem insurmountable. And then a year later, we can look back at them and we see some of them, were removed. Some of them moved out of the way. Some of them we were able to overcome. Some of them we were able to outwit and figure out. And yet some were still there. I think all of us have had our expectations dashed. And we've had certain feelings of fear and fright. And anger and flight. Definitely been some of that. Our emotional responses have been all over the map. And we've tried to remind ourselves, at least in this community, of our instruction, of Jesus' instruction that love is the bottom line. How are we continue to working and living in love for our neighbor and one another and ourselves. And so, with regard to our ministry here, we did many of the needful things, the things that we needed to do. I could list them all, but I just want to focus on the pantry for a moment. One of the needful things was to make sure that people had food, that people were fed and cared for. So we went from serving 30 people a month to 100 people a week. And sure, when that started, there were obstacles. There were big stones in the way, so it seemed. Where were we going to get all this food? Where was it going to come from? And it has come. You should see Luther Hall in the back room. It's jammed full of food. Because of not only you all, but our other communities of faith, from Beth Tikva to St. Jones to Christ Presbyterian to the Indian Cultural Center to residents of Marlton, to young children having their own food drives to bring food here, to bring hope and life to others. So what I like about this resurrection story is that it feels real. It feels like this is the place where we are. We've heard about Jesus rising from the dead. We've seen glimpses, maybe even in our own life, of parts of us that have died and new parts that have birthed. But what does that mean? What does it really mean that Jesus was raised from dead? We haven't seen him. And in this gospel, these women haven't seen him yet either. And so sometimes we are afraid and we become still. Sometimes we lash out and fight. But then we are remembered that this time is like the young man reminds them. He reminds them of the promise. The promise of the beginning of the gospel. That Jesus, that the presence of divine love is with us. Can you hold on to that hope? Can you hope in that promise? Can you trust and have faith to step into it? To step into and do the next needful thing to experience life. No matter what the obstacles are, no matter what the difficulties are, no matter how our expectations are shaken, to still hold on to the sense of trust and hope that this way of love that conquers difficulties, that conquers even death, is the way. Know that as the promise in today's gospel is, that Jesus says he's out ahead of us. Divine love is out ahead of us, leading into life. And I like how it especially mentions Peter. And make sure Peter knows, the one who denied. Make sure everyone knows, even if we've strayed or walked away or confused or uncertain, that everyone knows that divine life is out leading us in the way, divine love, and may we hold on to it. Alleluia. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Alleluia. I invite us to sing the hymn of the day.
Is the victory of our time.
we prepare to offer prayers today, just wanted to share with you a couple people we want to remember in prayer. Guy has some friends, believe it or not, Phyllis and Nick both fell at different times, but also are having some additional health concerns related to that. So if we remember for Phyllis and Nick. Also, I ask that we continue to keep Jim Strengfeld in our prayers. Many of you know that he was diagnosed with ALS this summer. This week he was hospitalized to have a permanent feeding tube put in. So please remember Jim and Diane in your prayers. Also, those of you who were here at the services earlier in the week, I mentioned that one of our young people, Haley Scherf, was quite ill with COVID, and she's actually improving greatly at this point, so we're very thankful for that. If you would continue to remember Haley, though, and her family in prayer. And finally, one of Guy's friends, Sean Clancy, fell off of a balcony earlier in the week and died due to the injuries while on a trip. So we will remember Sean in our prayers as well. Trusting in God's promise of new life, we pray for the renewal of the church, the world, and all of creation.
Alleluia. God, you are resurrection. Bring joy to your church as we spread the good news that Jesus is risen. Lead us to proclaim this message with persistence and confidence. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Alleluia. God, you are creator. Open our eyes to the first fruits of new life around us, to budding trees, nourishing rains, warm breezes, and freshly tilled soil. Inspire our gratitude and renew our commitment to stewardship of the earth. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Alleluia. God, you are reconciliation. You show no partiality among the nations, but instead call all people to the way of peace. Bring an end to conflict and division. Renew leaders and advocates for peace with a commitment to the common good. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Alleluia. God, you are strength. Awaken hope and perseverance in all who need to hear a word of life this day. Those who are hungry, anxious, oppressed, despairing, or sick. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Alleluia. God, you are life. We give you thanks for all the newly baptized, who by water and your word are forever joined to Christ's death and resurrection. Embolden all who share this baptized life and renew us in faith and in action. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Alleluia. God, you are comfort. Draw near to all who grieve. Refresh us with the promise that you will destroy death, and that with all the saints, including Sean Clancy, we will be made alive forever in Christ. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. We commend these and all our prayers to you, O God. Come near to us with your saving help. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our risen Savior. Amen. I invite you to stand. The risen Christ came and stood among the disciples and said, "Peace be with you."
And also with you.
I invite you to stand and turn around and share peace by waving or offering your heart to one another.
Peace be with you.
invite you to be seated as we listen to a special offering that has been prepared for us by the Bell Choir, who gathered in a special and safe way to record a couple pieces for us. Thank you for those who continue to support the life and work of our congregation through your offerings. There is a box back there for offerings if you have any with you today. We'd be most thankful for them. You may put them there at any time during the service. I invite us to stand. They just like really sharing their gifts. Let us pray. God of love, you call us beloved children and welcome us to this your table. Receive our lives and the gifts we offer. Abide with us and send us in service to a suffering world. For the sake of your beloved child, Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to God.
Let us give thanks to Christ our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. It is indeed right. Our duty and joy that we would at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ, the true Paschal Lamb, who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death, and in rising has brought us to eternal life. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Are you, O God of the universe, Your mercy is everlasting. Your faithfulness endures from age to age. Praise to you for creating the heavens and the earth. Praise to you for saving the earth from the waters of the flood. Praise to you for bringing the Israelites safely through the sea. Praise to you for leading your people through the wilderness to the land of milk and honey. Praise to you for the words and deeds of Jesus, your anointed one. Praise to you for the death and resurrection of Christ. Praise to you for your spirit poured out on all nations. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after the supper, he took the cup and gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, "In this cup is the new covenant promise in my blood, shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." With this bread and cup, we remember our Lord's Passover from death to life as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Hope and glory are our breath, merciful God, for you have rolled away the stone of despair, the stone of oppression, the stone of lament, the stone of grief, the stone of death, the stone of sin, the stone of fear. Come and stand among us and breathe on us your peace. Breathe on us your power. Breathe on us your eternal life. That all who labor, all who stumble, all who hunger, and all who fall shall meet you in the breaking of the bread and be lifted up by your touch. Shape your church to be your risen body. Make our scars beautiful like your scars. Make our lives life-giving like your life. Make our communion holy with all your saints. Until you come again in glory and we eat with you in your kingdom. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
With boldness, we pray the prayer that Jesus taught. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Alleluia! Christ is risen! Christ is risen indeed! Alleluia!
Now let us feast on this Easter day on the bread of life. Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
We'll sing together the Lamb of God. I will come around with communion, and when I approach and if you want to receive, I invite you to stand and I'll place the bread in your hand.
Take away the sin of all.
Let us pray. Wellspring of joy, through this meal you have put gladness in our hearts. Satisfy the hunger still around us, and send us as joyful witnesses that your love may bring joy to the hearts of all your people. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Sovereign. Amen. May God, who brought us from death to life, fill you with great joy. And may Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Amen. Invite us to sing together our final hymn, Alleluia, Jesus is Risen. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. You are the body of Christ raised up for the life of the world. Go in peace. Share the good news. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. I invite you as you leave today to be sure to greet one another with Easter greetings. God bless. Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.